Hello there, NAEP fans. My name is Grady Wilburn. I'm a statistician at the National Center for Education Statistics, and I'm here today to present to you one of our coolest tools, if I do say so myself. This tool will be useful for parents, teachers, anybody who has school-aged children around them. And this is called, or the tool I'm going to share is called the NAEP Questions Tool, or the NQT. Teachers, you can use this tool to create quizzes or tests or worksheets for your students. And parents, you can use this tool throughout the year to keep your students academically engaged throughout the mini breaks, fall break, spring break, winter break, or currently we're in our summer break. Speaking of summer, I don't know if you all have heard of this term called summer learning loss. The definition is kind of in the title. It's the loss of learning over the summer. And what research has shown is that over the summer, your student can actually lose a month's worth of schooling. So imagine taking your student out of school for a month. That's the loss that occurs over the summer. And the research suggests that keeping your student academically engaged throughout those breaks can actually combat that loss and maybe even give them an advantage when that next school year starts or when that break ends. Now, what better way to keep them academically engaged than the NAEP Questions tool? So I'm gonna show you today how to use that tool and hopefully present it in a way that allows you to use it for your school-aged child or student. But first, I just want to see who we have visiting with us today. I don't know if we have any teachers or principals, school administrators. If you could just comment in the chat box, I'd like to get an idea of whom I'll be speaking with. If you have experience with our tools, any of our NAEP field staff, it would be great just to see who we have joining us today. I'm turning to the left because that's where the screen is, so just to let you all know. Okay, it looks like we have some people that are shy on their keyboards, and that's okay. I see we have some viewers. So I think what I'll do is just pretend that you all know absolutely nothing about the tools, and I'll walk you through as best I can. And remember, you don't have to necessarily take notes. This video will be archived later on our YouTube channel, so you can come back and watch it as often as you would like. But why don't we go ahead and get started? So the first place you want to go is nationsreportcard.gov. That houses all of our reports, but also all of our data tools. And what you want to do is just click on Data Tools. And here you'll see some of our data tools. You have our state districts tool, our NAEP Data Explorer, our item maps, and then our questions tool over here. And that's the one that we're going to go through today. So you just click on Try Questions. And here you see our NAEP questions tool. Now it's going to bring you to our public site, nces.ed.gov. Okay. All right, there we go. And we have a few different options when you come to our questions tool. We have the search questions feature. That's the one I'm going to go through today. We have our test yourself feature, and we also have create tests. And I'm going to touch on those two a little bit later. But for today, I'm just going to focus on our search questions tool here. Now, I do want to mention that you can create an account. And in order to take advantage of all of the different aspects and features of the questions tool, you should create an account. And in order to do so, all you do is just create an account, you type your email address in here, you click send email, and then it'll give you a link to click in which you could figure out how to create an account. And to create an account, or when you create an account, it opens up all sorts of advantages, like you can save tests, you can save items, upload roster lists. It kind of unlocks all the different features of the tool. Now, I obviously already have an account, so I'm just going to sign in on mine. And I do want to add that signing in does not mean you're going to now all of a sudden start receiving a whole bunch of junk mail or spam from NAEP. The only reason to create an account is just so that you can save the list. You will not be put on any sort of NAEP listservs or anything like that. So I don't want you to worry about that. So what I'm going to do here is create on search questions. Wait for that to open up. It's going through our hundreds and hundreds of questions. I'm a math fan, so I'm going to just pick on math first, but you see all the different subjects that we have there. We release items after every assessment for the most part, so the general public can get an idea of the type of items that we put in front of the students we assess. And for those of you all not familiar with NAEP, we only test grades 4, 8, and 12, so that's how our items will be organized. So here you see some different menus. So I'm going to focus on algebra today, but as you see, there's a lot of different options here, geometry, measurement. So whatever content area that you want to focus on, you would just select that one. As you see, I selected algebra. I'm going to select multiple choice questions. I'm going to select all years to give me a better chance of getting more items. And then I'm going to click on the medium questions. Now, I mentioned this before, but all of these items have previously been assessed on other students. So this difficulty is organized by the success the students had on those particular items. So for example, easy items mean that 60% of the student population got that item correct, 60% or more. For medium, it's between 40 and 59% of students got it correct. And for hard, that's 40% or less students got that question correct. So I'm gonna click on medium. And I wanna get about 30 questions here just to give you all kind of an assortment of the different kind of questions we have. I'm just gonna go over here and click on get count. And as you see here, it gave us about 32 questions, which is a good number. Now, I could have filtered this a little bit more by looking at the abilities or the complexity. But again, I think I wanted to focus on just getting a good amount of questions to show you. So I'm just going to click OK. Now, what this is doing is it's going through all the questions given the criteria that I clicked here, and then it's going to pull all of those items out. And now you can see all of these items in a grid format. So you see the description here, the grade, the year it was assessed. You don't need to pay too much attention to the block. We release a couple of blocks after each assessment, so that's just that data for you. The difficulty here, the type, I selected multiple choice, if you recall, but if I selected constructive response, you see a CR. And again, the content that I selected was algebra. If you selected different content, obviously you'd see all those here as well. Now this view works for a lot of people, but I kind of prefer the drag and drop view. So let's show it that way. It presents the items in a little more of a visually appealing way. So here you see all the items that we selected. And a brief description of each item. Identify graph representing a situation. I like that item. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag that over here. And as you can see, now I have one question in my bank. But maybe you want to get a little more description of what the actual item is. So down here, you could just click Show Question. And then here's the question. This is the exact question that the student saw when taking the math assessment. So here's the question. Here are the answer options. Now, all of us aren't that great in math, so of course you want to know what the actual answer is. You can do that by clicking here, or just clicking on our key scoring guide, and here you see what the answer was. This is letter E. Now, sample responses from multiple choice won't show you much, but if we had selected a constructed response item, you would actually see PDFs of sample responses at the different categories, partially correct, fully correct, incorrect, just so you can get an idea of what a correct answer or incorrect answer looks like. But we also have performance data, and here you can see the percentage of students that selected all of the different answer options. So as you see, the correct answer was E, the correct answer was E, as illustrated by the asterisk here, and 42% of students selected E, but you can also see that 21% of students like to see. So it gives you an idea of kind of what the students, the eighth grade students that had this question, how they answered it. Okay, so let's go back to this adding questions function here. So again, you could take the item, you can drag it over here, and again, in order to do this feature, you have to have created an account to select these questions. You can push this button, you can add all the questions, or if the question comes up, you can just click add question if you don't want to do the whole drag and drop thing. And you see that my questions are adding up here. I have four questions there. Let me add a few more. Let's add that one. Okay, so as you see, I have six questions there. Now I have a couple of options here. I think what I'd want to do is maybe create a printout that I'd want to give my son or my daughter or the student in my family or life that I want to ask these questions to. So what I would do, I would just click on download. And what this allows you to do is to create the questions in an HTML or Excel or PDF format so that you can print it out and give it to your students to complete. Looks like we're taking a little longer than it should here. I may have to reload this page. Yeah. Let's try that. All right. So I did it previously just in case something like this happened. So here you see what would happen. You have all the items that you printed out, and you just have the question, and then you have the answer options. Now, they don't have the correct choices on here because if you're giving this to your student as a test, you don't want them to see the correct answer. But that you would pull from the previous screen that I just showed you. So there are other options here. Let's see. You can publish a test online. This is an interesting thing in which you could upload a roster list and you can send your students a code in which they could sign in. And if you recall on the previous page, they would enter a code in and then you could give them however much time you wanted to have them complete. And you can get an indication of when they finish that test. You get some sort of email or response saying, so-and-so student finished the test. And that's your cue to go in, grade the test, give them feedback, so on and so forth. So hopefully, you teachers out there and you parents can see how this tool may be useful. So that was a pretty short demonstration, but I think hopefully you all kind of got the idea of the usefulness of this tool. Again, it's accessible via the nationsreportcard.gov, data tools, try questions. Now, like I mentioned, there's a couple of other features, the test yourself feature, the create test feature. I'd be happy to come back later and demonstrate how to use these features. You know, if this is something you want, please just see, you can email me, you can put a comment in the chat box, and maybe we'll come back at a later time if you all would find this useful. And go through some of our other tools, because I think parents and especially teachers, I think, will find a lot of these tools very useful. So, if there's any questions, I don't see any questions coming up. So I must have just done a remarkable job in explaining this so clearly. Oh, there is a question. Can you show a sample reading question? I think I can do that. So we'll go search question. So again, these are all the different subjects that we assess. So I'll just click on reading. I don't know if there's a grade preference, but maybe I'll just go grade 4 since I did grade 8 before. And then again, I'll click. We have all these different content classifications that you could kind of filter your questions by. I don't think I'll select one. I'll just do a multiple choice. Let's do some easy ones. Let's select all years. And let's see how many questions that yields. Gave us 73. So again, you would just click OK. And here all of the different reading questions pop up. And you can see if you forget what you clicked, you have your subject here, the grade you picked, as well as the different years you selected. Content classification was all, and I did multiple choice and an easy difficulty level. And again, if you want to see the question, you just click Show Question. Here's a question that was asked. Now, if there was a stimulus to the question, like they had to read a short paragraph or something like that, that would also be passed. I'd also be here, and as you see, it says reading passage. So this is the passage that goes along with the item that I just showed you. And then performance data, just to see how students did on this item. 70% of students selected the correct answer. So hopefully you found that useful. Are there any more questions? Well, I think that's it for today. So again, I'm hoping you found this all useful. Again, if there's other tools that you all have experience with that you want us to do a similar tutorial video with, we're happy to do that. Just please either send me an email, comment in the chat section, and we'd be happy to follow up with you. Again, this video will be archived on our YouTube page. I think there'll probably also be a link on either or both our Facebook and Twitter page for you to look at over and over again as long as you find it helpful. Please follow us on Twitter, NAEP_NCES, or Facebook at the National Assessment of Educational Progress. I'm Grady Wilburn. Thanks again for your time and enjoy the rest of your day.